With Clover, you can print orders on a merchant's device solely through REST API requests. If you're a web developer, you don't need to worry about Android development or creating APKs. Our print API keeps your app fully on the web as you focus on your online ordering solution. With a standard ordering flow, a customer browses available items and adds their selections to their cart. When they're finished, they review their order and pay. Over on the merchant end, the order is printed. In the case of restaurants, this lets the kitchen know what to start working on when. Clover has atomic order endpoints for the initial browsing and order creation phases, and there's e-commerce to take card-not-present payments. For the final printing step, Clover's print event endpoint takes an order UUID and fires details directly to the merchant's printer. You can call this API whenever you need to, right away after payment for an ASAP order, or further down the line if you offer scheduled orders. Let's see what this looks like in practice by setting up a print event request in Postman. Note that if you want to follow along, your test app will need the order's write permission. This is because printing an order technically changes an order. An order's line items have a Boolean field named printed. This gets set to true once the order successfully prints. Our URL in Postman is the standard merchant path and uses the base URL for the environment you're working in, such as sandbox.dev.clover.com for sandbox. We're making a post request and we'll need an API token for the merchant to authorize it. See our video on OAuth for more about setting this up. Note the merchant UUID in the path. We'll also need the order UUID for the body. Make sure your dev kit is on and send your request. The order receipt will print to the default device printer. In the wild, you can confirm the print request was successful with webhooks. As mentioned, printing an order changes it, so you'll receive an order update webhook. Double-check that the order's line items show that they've been printed, and you're good to go. Notice how I said, make sure your dev kit is on? What happens if the printer is offline? If you want to check in on the status of the print event, you'll need the matching order's read permission. Set up your request. This time around, we're using a GET request with the print event UUID in the URL path. The possible return states include created, printing, or failed. Note that checking the state like this is most useful for an unhappy path, such as when you don't receive the expected order update webhook. Once the order completes successfully, the print event is deleted, leaving the order's line items to confirm success. In the case of a failure, Clover automatically emails the merchant if the order hasn't completed printing after 2 minutes. The order will still print within an hour if the device comes back online, such as in the case of faulty Wi-Fi. After an hour, however, the print attempt is discarded. Maybe the merchant turned their devices off for the night, or they lost power. Either way, they aren't in a position to take online orders if their devices aren't online. These automatic retries mean that you don't generally need to resubmit the print request yourself. If the order receipt should still be considered valid after the allotted hour, you can certainly resend the request then, but it won't be successful until the merchant regains connectivity. But let's assume the merchant received their order receipt. Their printer will produce something like this, or this. The print event endpoint itself didn't provide any customization options. The resulting receipt is instead based on a merchant's standard settings. The merchant controls the appearance of their order receipts. They know best whether they care about using alternate inventory names, whether the receipts should include order numbers, or how much extra space they need at the top of the receipt. However, if your solution requires a certain element to be present, such as the order note. You can set that for the merchant. Just know it's probably a good idea to let the merchant know you're doing so. Order receipt setup options are listed under the merchant properties endpoint. If that amount of customization is still too limited for your use case, or if other aspects of the print API don't quite fit with what you're trying to do, Clover offers a variety of other printing options as well. We won't go into detail here, but you may want to check out one of the following. While the print API means that you don't need to create an Android APK for your app to print, you get some extra options if you do. Clover's Android SDK provides options to not only print an order receipt, but also a payment receipt, or something completely different. Semi-integrations have their own printing options. For example, if you're using Remote Pay, Clover Connector has a print method that takes a print request. You can even customize receipts without directly handling printing. In the developer dashboard, go to your app settings and select Receipt Customizations. This lets you add a URL or text to customer receipts. However you decide to print, completely from the web with our print API, or with an Android or Semiint component, we look forward to seeing what you build.